When exploring in the mountains, when adventuring, on-mountain navigation is key. So today we're gonna see how to navigate with a good old-fashioned map and compass. Here are a few cases where on-mountain navigation is going to be key. First of all, if you're gonna be caught out in the mountains in winter in a whiteout. Like everything is white, you don't know where you're at. For nighttime travel, navigating through exposed terrain, navigating on a glacier, trying to find the top of a line, especially if it's got cornices at the top and you can't really access the ridge in a safe way. Also, if you're touring or riding through dense woods and you need to find your ways. And last but not least, if you're on a big touring mission and all of a sudden you want to change your itinerary, change plans because the conditions are not what you expected or something happens, then you're gonna have to figure it out. I personally love 3D mapping and I use FATMAP because there are like so many different filters that I can use to either find some exposed terrain, like find my way, have a really good understanding of my surrounding.
This, for example, allows you to watch what's around you. So if you're in a whiteout, this is an amazing feature.
But there are limitations to this. You know, in the mountains, when it's cold, you might have no more batteries on your phone. You might be out of signal and you haven't uploaded your map before. You know, there are many cases, scenario where electronics have limitations. So one option that you can do is to always have a paper map in your bag. Well, if you go on a big mission and yeah, if you feel that your batteries are running out, like try to make sure to pinpoint your location and it's going to tell you the exact coordinates and then you can use them on your map to know already where you're at this point, because knowing your first position is key. So first of all, it's important to set the declination. This is the difference between true north and magnetic north. So it's going to be written on all the maps. It's going to tell you, depending on where you're at, on how much you should set that declination. What can I distinguish around me, which I could then find again on the map? If you have the chance to recognize two reference points around you, you can trace a bearing and cross them together, and that will give you a rough estimate of your position. So I can distinguish this peak and this peak. The first point of reference is up there, so I'm gonna point my compass towards it, and I'm going to align the red needle with a red arrow. Like from the Mont Gelé, like 144 degrees. And now I've got visibility on that one peak over there. I'm gonna cross this line and then this other line. So that gives me a rough estimate of being within that zone here. So if there are no points of reference around you, if you really struggle to know where you're at, one way to do it is to turn back a little bit until the last reference point you had. If you don't need to be too precise on your way and your direction, you can actually angle your map to have the north of the map and the true north being in the same direction, and that will quickly give you a rough idea of where you're at and where things and which direction you need to take. So I know where I am at. I'm at the top of the Mont Rogneux. And I'm gonna direct my map towards the magnetic north. And I'm gonna align the red arrow pointing towards the north. Okay, so if I leave the map in this position, it's going to be easy to find out where the peaks are. So, okay, I know that all this ridge is this ridge that I see here. Mont Gelé is up here. So I know that I'm on this peak now, and I want to go to this peak right here. So I'm going to take with a ruler, I'm going to angle it in the right direction. So that gives me the right direction. And you can see the white stripes within the bezel, and I'm going to align them with the stripes of the map. So then after that, I'm going to match the red needle with the red arrow, and this is going to give me the right direction. So I can walk around just following this direction and it will be good. So you're gonna see on all the maps, there's always a scale. So it's really good with a ruler, like to being able to measure how much like a kilometer will be. So that's 4 centimeters. So that's gonna give you an idea like wherever you want to go. The more you train, the more you will be able to have a good idea of the time it will take you to cover however much distance. Et voilà, this is not rocket science, but a super important thing is to always plan your itinerary as much as you can before you go out on an adventure, because the more information you have already in your head, the less you're gonna have to figure it out on the terrain. Enjoy out there, be happy to learn, and have a great season.